gonna do a super quick video. We've had a request from a client where they want service pages like these. And on each service page, they want a color that's specific to that service that determines the H1 for the page, this background over here, and a gradient in the footer. And that'll change for each server. So if we go back to the page, and this is all in Swedish, by the way, you'll see that over here we've got this dark blue, it's changing to blue at the bottom. What's this one? We've got green. And we wanted to make it super simple for them and allow them to always just be able to use the editor. It's a clinic, they're not tech inclined, they want to create new services. Or change service colors or update anything, just use the editor, select color. But of course, you can't do that because in Webflow, when you select the background element's color, it overrides the gradient that you have. So there's no stop and start. But it's super easy to do this. So all you need is a color, which let's hop into Webflow. It's a bit slow today, so let's see what happens. Care services. So we've got, it's not loading. Give it a sec. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No, there's a whole bunch of notices about dashboard issues, but okay. So basically you just need the colors you want for your gradient. We're only using one because this guy is going from the secondary color, the gradient color for this, CMS item to transparent. And then you need an embed, which we've got hiding over here. And this is where you will set up the actual colors to pull from the CMS on this collection list page. So we're on the services template page. And I'm just gonna show you what it actually looks like. So one of the reasons we did this as well is to make things a little simpler. We've got one footer, with one gradient color for most of the site, and we didn't want to break the symbol, right? So if you open up the symbol, where is it? Footer. Oh, edit main. You'll see we've got a linear gradient in here. It's not this gradient. It's the default gradient. We're just overriding it with the gradient color embed. So let's hop back into that. And I'm just going to show you what you need to do. Codes in the post. All you need to do is take the element you want to change, background color of. In this case, we've already got a background color for that gradient from the rest of the site. So we're going to override it by adding an important at the back here. And we're going to say we want the footer, which is down there, to have a background image linear gradient. 180 degrees starting at transparent and going to our secondary color. So all you need to do is select your color, secondary page color. There we have that, and insert that there. We've got 100% here, you can adjust that, but I think on the actual colors, they brought their primary color that's on the title here down, that secondary page color, to 50%. So yeah, it's technically 50. And that's literally that. The element you want to style, footer, background, linear gradient, you can change that to radial or whatever. You can put in a start color if you want. We've got a start color that's transparent for all of them. And it ends in this guy at 100%, and it's important to override because we already have a background gradient on there. And now I'm just going to break this. There we go. Save and close, and you'll see it's gone back to that sort of faded blue that they have on the rest of the site, articles and stuff. And the moment you change this, you'll see it's working immediately. See, save and close, and boom, you've got the color for that gradient. And switch, sorry, that's some background stuff happening there. Color for this gradient, color for this gradient, this guy, ignore him, he's a scroller, He's just got some background blending on him to make him disappear. And that's literally it. Publish and you are done. The code is on the blog post that's linked in the comments here. You can just copy, paste, and adapt it to your needs. Hope this video helps you, and if you have any issues, you can comment in the blog post or on the video, although I'm probably better answering comments in the blog post. And yeah, like and subscribe to stay up to date with new tutorials. Check out our analytics tutorials, there's quite a few of them. Cheers.